Your Excellency, the President, Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, President Muhammadu Buhari. Your Excellency, the Governor of Imo State, and of course, representing the governors of the Niger Delta region, the Deputy Governor of Imo State, the Deputy Leader of the National Assembly, in fact, by implication, the Senate, my dear brother, Senator Borofis, His Excellency, the Governor of Yobe State, should be outside, maybe at the tent, and so many other dignitaries, the very distinguished traditional fathers present, including the former Governor of Rivers State, Dieter Spiff, the members of the National Assembly, particularly the two chairmen of the committees who have spoken. Because of time, I do know that Senator Abe and so many others, including our brother Jasper Jumbo and so many, have a lot to say, but of course, including my sister Angie Briggs, we have the tents outside. We will go and do the necessary speeches there. But this one is a bit tight, so I have, even me, I have just a few minutes, and we have a lot of people from outside who came to join us in the joy of today. It's a great pleasure for me as a minister to officially welcome you all to the commissioning of this corporate headquarters complex of the Niger Delta Development Commission. It is indeed another milestone which evidences the commitment of Mr. President towards the development of Nigeria, particularly the Niger Delta region. So I'm grateful to Almighty God for making this day a reality. And I welcome you all, the governors, of course, the ministers, the traditional fathers, my dear brother, the Minister of State, Senator Tayo Olashodura, the permanent secretaries, and all the youth leaders who are here from across the Niger Delta region in their numbers, both inside and outside in the tents. It could be recalled that the edifice we are commissioning today, started by us, started so many years ago, so I won't mention that. I won't mention the fact that it started about 26 years ago. Neither will I mention the fact that I was the first, I happened to be the first minister of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, in fact, the first person from the presidency to visit this edifice since 1996. That day I came with the former administrator, the former managing director, Mrs. Enya Akwaga, she's here. And the few staff I met on ground, they told me, sir, you are the first person that, and then you are they told her, madam, you are the first MD since 1996 to be here. No MD had ever visited this place. The place was waterlocked, it was swampy and all that. And I went back and reported to the National Assembly members that we have a job to do. I reported to Mr. President, and he gave marching orders that they must move from where they were paying rent to this place, and then to the glory of God, we have achieved that. May I even mention the fact that, to my greatest shock, for over 15 years, Senator Abu Ibrahim and all the other distinguished leaders of the Northern who are here to witness this occasion, what has befallen the NDDC will never happen to Northeast Development Commission. That is why I'm happy you all came in your numbers to see this day. Do you know that even the head office they were using on a rented platform, they did not connect it to the national grid for over 15 years so that they can give us contracts of diesel? So that became a different racket on its own. And as a matter of fact, we have connected it to the national grid, even though we are going to hand over to the owners. I want to thank the President for the love he has for the Niger Delta region. And to say that, Mr. President, this is a monument that will stand to remember you in history positively. The East-West Road that you are committed to completing started in 2006. But together we have pledged that by this time next year, you also commission Section 1 to 4, which is from Efurum Warri area all the way to Oron, and the good people of Niger Delta will also be grateful to you. Generations will never forget you, Mr. President. So for me, I don't want you to listen to what is on the social media. Because when you started the construction of the second Niger Bridge, some people said, why are they making noise? Is he the one that discovered bridge making? And others have forgotten that since 1960, the second Niger Bridge had always been on the drawing board. You took it out of the drawing board, and very soon we are going to see a second Niger Bridge. As I speak to you now, between Ogoni and Akwa Ibom in Ikorabasi, we have used only one bridge for the past 16 years. But as I'm speaking now, by next week, or thereabout, or by April this year, we are going to commission the second bridge done by RCC to the glory of God for the benefit of the people of Niger Delta. And we are redesigning the whole of Eleme Junction with interjection and flyover. By the time we are through with this region, you will not recognize the Niger Delta again. And kudos to Mr. President. Let me say that you have undertaken so many projects that were abandoned by previous governments. You are not shying away from it because of the love you have for Nigeria. Even when people are talking about Lagos Ibadan railway line, they talk about maybe Lagos, Kano, Maiduguri, and all that. And we have just recently done the groundbreaking ceremony for Bonny rail line across southeast all the way down to Maiduguri. All these projects are meant for the future generation of Nigerians. Mr. President, I get a bit emotional when I watch the fact that it has taken you to come and liberate us infrastructurally. And taking cognizance of the fact that these things are being done in a period of pandemic when many countries cannot pay salaries. I think if nobody can praise you, God Almighty will praise you by giving you strength of character and giving you long life and helping the rest of us who are committed to your vision to helping you to realize your dream for Nigeria. I know that time is not there, but I want to thank the interim administrator, my brother Ifeoma Okwai, and the past interim management committees. Members have mentioned the former managing director, who was in acting capacity, for the commitment, because when I came here and I said, we must do this, they doubted me, but working day and night, we have been able to achieve it. I know that, yes, indeed, the Niger Delta region is in dire need of development. I know that the Lebele people in Bayelsa said their barely bridge collapsed many years ago, and they are using canoes to look for drinking water. I know that the Ogoni cleanup that was on paper is now a reality and is undergoing, and very soon Ogoni people will have clean drinking water. I do know that the people who are now on amnesty program, we will not want adult delinquency in future. Very soon, we have to plan for the post-amnesty initiative by ensuring that NDDC partners with reputable organizations to build industries and bring small and medium-scale industries to this region to employ our children. Thousands of children blocked me at the hotel when I was leaving this morning. And what are they looking for? Maybe stipends. I was in tears because they would not have done what they did today if they had jobs to do. So, Your Royal Majesties, the region must cooperate with this administration to move forward. There is no need for people to have the paraphernalia of security. You have the police, you have the SSS, you have all. And those are the ones that help you to sleep in the night. And then you come out and say the presidency is deceiving people. Without even the president, you can't sleep, even if you are a governor. Some of them have not asked themselves, what have we done with the 13% derivation? But yet, they will open their mouth and talk about the presidency in very demeaning terms. I want Mr. President to ignore those things. Yes, Ifeoma Okwai, you would not have been here because they were able to penetrate the system. Even the Code of Conduct Bureau invited you today to appear today. When we fixed 25th of February for the first commissioning, they invited him on that same 25th. Is it not ourselves that are killing ourselves? Niger Delta people, why can't we realize that petition writing and destructive tendencies, Senator Gumel, those are the things bringing down the region. It's not outsiders that came to destroy this place. Trillions have been spent, but nothing has been seen on ground. When the Akwa Ibom was created out of Cross River State, when I became a governor, I saw something terrible. The asset sharing was totally inadequate because they left the infrastructure in Cross River State and brought petition writers to Akwa Ibom. We must revisit that asset sharing so that we can return some of the petition writers to Cross River State in order to balance the situation. Unfortunately, as Minister of Niger Delta, I've come to see that it perverts the entirety of Niger Delta. God Almighty will help us. May God bless Mr. President for this edifice. This complex will improve the lives of the people of Niger Delta. The ancillary building is going to be for commercial purpose. It has a place for hospital. It has a place for banking. It has a place for banqueting. It has a place for restaurants, for outsiders and all that. And then this place with 13 floors, with multiple lifts and all that, this is where it should be. Even if the United Nations Secretary General comes here today, he will have respect for Niger Delta. God bless all of you for listening. And may God bless Mr. President for this. Thank you, and God bless you all. Thank you.